In May, in the year of our Lord, 1701, I, Ambrosius, and my brother monk Dominicus were sent from our monastery and went to another one, some distance in the mountains. We went to replace two dear brothers who had died of a terrible wasting disease. We feared that the plague might greet us there, but we had no choice but to do as we were told. Our only wish was to follow the teachings and the footsteps of Christ, and to obey the church always. Dominicus, I confess, I enjoyed having those women kissing my hands. I noticed they kissed mine more than yours.
Then you're both guilty of lust and pride, Ambrosius.
I don't know.
You should pray hard and often. You're a shameful case.
God knows.
No doubt. I will put you in my prayers. Crazy.
Where are you? Why are you here?
You blind monk? Shoo! Scaring away the vultures. Shoo! Fly away!
Are you related to him? What was his name? What was his crime?
He killed some bastard over a woman. Or maybe he was under a woman. Who knows?
Do you know this criminal?
No.
And you are here, scaring away vultures.
When anyone is hanged here, I scare away the vultures. Is that a sin?
What is your name?
Benedicta.
Who are your parents?
My mother is dead.
My father, where is he? Benedicta, where do you live?
I live everywhere, though my house is there.
Here?
I'm told the most remarkable thing in this part of the country is the salt mining. The salt works provide endless employment for the young men. The salt master, he enjoys as much power in this region as our superior. The salt master is appointed by the Duke and holds all judicial powers in his hands. Rokas, the salt master's only and lonely son.
Hey! Please!
Thank you.
You are sick!
The monks distill a liquor from roots found in the mountains. And this liquor has become famous throughout the land. So strong and fiery with spices that when you drink it, your throat burns like a flame from hell.
I greet you, Benedicta.
Are you afraid?
I can't. Please, go away.
Come inside. Come. obey God, fear no man.
Thank you, my Lord.
I'm no Lord, Benedicto. Pray to God. He will help you. And so will I.
Those flowers are hard to find. You have to be crazy or an angel to find them. They only grow on the mountaintops. They are so beautiful.
Have you reported this to Brother Joseph?
Of course I did. I showed him the flowers at the altar, right in front of our blessed San Franciscus.
And what did you say?
Toss the bread.
What? What did Brother Joseph say?
The same thing I said. A miracle. This is a miracle.
Praise be to God.
Excuse me, Father. Brother Joseph told me you want to speak to me.
Sit.
My son, you must remember that you renounce your own will for God's sake. You have the looks of a sincere monk yet at Mass. You spoke to an undesirable penitent, the Girl Benedicta. A serious offense. She's a despicable outcast.
But Father...
Quiet! I know what she is. This has caused quite a bit of gossip. And I hate gossip. Why did you do it, my son?
I pity the girl.
She's the hangman's daughter and the criminal. The daughter of a criminal. The granddaughter of a criminal, for the love of God. If we could get rid of crime, Then we would rid ourselves of hangmen and a dirty breed. For now, the best thing to do is to avoid all contact with such garbage. We have useful things to do here in the monastery. Understood?
Yes, Father.
For you, Brother Ambrosius, this girl does not exist. Go to your cell. Stay there. Chastise yourself until you know in your heart the meaning of obedience and humility. Go.
Hey there, you, monk. That's right, you. You're new here. Maybe that's why you made such an ass of yourself in church the other day.
I meant no offense.
Well, you offended me. And if you ever come near Benedicta again, I'll teach you a lesson in real humility. You monks think you can hide behind your so-called virtue, but I know what you want. Make no mistake, you're as horny as the rest of us. You've been warned.
You'll pay for that. Thank you.
from me.
I want to dance with a real woman.
All right. Drunk bastards.
Who's coming with me?
I've watched you and Benedicta. Rocco's is going to her house now to get her. She doesn't have a chance against that bully. No woman does.
What can I do? I'm just a monk.
You can save the bitch. Run. Warn her. Hurry!
I can't. They'll get there first.
No. I know a faster way to the hangman's house. Well, come on.
Show me the way.
Everybody hates Benedicta. This is just like Rocco's. Everybody hates the slut. So, he loves her. I should kill her. Rocco says she has a pretty face. I can make it bigger. With a knife! There. That's where the bitch lives. You better go.
Benedicta, it's me, Ambrosius, brother Ambrosius. Don't be afraid.
What's wrong? What happened?
A bunch of drunken boys are on their way here with Rocco's. He will make you go with them. I'm here to help you. They are drunk. They could do anything. Listen. Hey.
Don't worry, Father.
Benedicta, quickly.
Where are we? Let's go back. We're never going to find this place.
Let's go back.
The witch ran right into Rocco's arms. Next time, I'll kill her myself. You see? She played you for a fool, monk. You let her. Now I know why you were a monk. You are not much of a man. I hope you enjoyed dancing with me. I'm sure you think I enjoyed dancing with you. Good night.
What? Benedicta, wait! So, once again, we have the little monk playing games.
I hate you, you pathetic, insolent, miserable frog.
Stop, Ambrosius! What is the meaning of this outrage?
This is all Benedicta's fault. She acts so pure and holy. Then she comes here and flaunts herself in front of everyone's face like a whore. It is not true!
I see. You better come along with me.
Entered the party only out of love for her father. He's sick. Benedicta didn't want him mistreated by Rocas. This is the truth.
Ridiculous. By the love of God, this whole matter has nothing to do with your duties in this monastery. You shall perform penance.
Dear God in heaven, please help me. Accepted as a sign from you that I was supposed to guide and protect Benedict. But maybe what I'm feeling is just a distraction of earthly love. I'll make you this promise. I will forget this girl. I will think only of the Holy Church. I promise. Pray for me, dear Franciscus. Pray for me.
I'll make this very simple for you. You disappoint me, my son.
That's a real surprise, Father. How many times does this make?
A man in your position cannot be a victim of circumstance. Never. You must lead. You don't follow. You're acting like an idiot. Chasing after the hangman's daughter. I want this stopped immediately.
But Excellency, it's not his fault. Everybody knows she was only there to seduce him. She's a devil, a slut.
Speaking of sluts, I don't remember asking you to sit down. Where's the sausage?
Leave us.
Yes, my lord. I'm just telling you what the whole town already knows. Benedicta has gone way too far. That's what the whole town says, my lord.
Okay. Benedicta is simply out of the question.
It's too cruel. It's too cruel. After all, we are civilized people now. It's not like in the old days.
You have no choice. Either the law has teeth, or it does not. This girl has become a nuisance. She must be stopped now. Besides, the merchants love public lashings.
Well, then it's settled. The matter rests with you now, Saltmaster. My domain is here within this wall. I care only for God's will.
Something you need, brother?
No, I was just passing by. I just wanted to know if there's something you need, brother.
You've been snooping again, haven't you? You have something to say.
Gossip is sinful.
Well,
I see I'm boring you with my...
All right. Out with it.
I just heard, accidentally, the Saltmaster and our superior talking about that girl, Benedicta. They said she would be punished.
Is that all?
Yes. You're angry with me?
No, of course not. Suspect me, my lady.
What are you doing here?
You tie a beautiful knot, Benedicta. Did you know that?
That is not an answer. What do you want, Rokas?
The sky is about to fall on your head, Benedicta.
But why? What have I done?
Because you danced with me. You are to be whipped at the post for all to see. I'm not as bad as you think I am. I'm going to help you. I'm taking you to the mountains, and we'll stay there as long as we need to. Forever. I promise you, we'll be safe.
Stop! Take your hands off my daughter, Rokas! So, you want to protect her, my lord? And do what? Turn her into your whore? Is that it, my lord?
There's no time for this, old man. I came here to help, and I am treated as an enemy. You have a strong arm. Very well. The strength of your arm will be used against her at the post. You will be responsible for her pain and humiliation.
You're out of my house, you pig!
Get up, Lazy. Come on. It's late. I made up the bed. Let's go. Come on, Rockets. Come on. For Christ's sake. Come on. Let's go.
Get out. I want to sleep.
No. No. This is my bed. I say who stays and who goes. Me. You can't push me around like that shitty little virgin.
You are under detention by order of our superior.
Rokas, you have put me in an embarrassing position. Because now you are going to have a trial.
I act in self-defense, and my own father condemns me.
I told you countless times to stay away from the hangman and his daughter.
Yes, you did. But why? Because all the people say you knew her mother? Perhaps Benedicta is your daughter.
Shut your mouth. Now, because you are my son, I will argue self-defense. Now get out of here. I am done with you.
So it's true.
Get out! This young monk has the gall to give his testimony, which contradicts all the available evidence. Even so, it is my conclusion that the accused Rokas, who happens to be my only son, did act against a community elder. But one thing is crystal clear. Rokas acted in self-defense. I ask your grace to give due consideration to that fact. Who else witnessed this affair?
I don't know, my lord.
No one else, your grace. All other monks were working about the grounds. This rebellious monk was doing penance.
In light of this witness, I find it... His grace has decided. He will defer to the South Master's judgment as to any punishment or penance due.
Wait a moment, physician. I didn't hear His Grace say any such thing. He did not agree.
There you have it. The Duke has sense.
Very well. It's my decision that a period of exile will be sufficient punishment. Yes, yes. Quite sufficient.
I must say, your recovery thus far is miraculous. God be praised. But you must be made worthy of such mercy. Therefore, I arranged that you leave us this morning for the mountains, to live apart from your brothers, apart from everyone. In solitude, you will restore your strength, and you will gain insight into your own heart.
How shall I do this?
You must examine your heart carefully. Then you will perceive the gravity of your error. You must ask God to shed His divine light upon your soul so that you may become His true priest and apostle, free from earthly desires and passions.
Thank you.
yes, it's true. These mountains are full of spirits. Big ones, little ones, goblins, witches, monsters. Sometimes they appear in shining clothes with long hair and wings. Beautiful. And they can seduce you if they want, because nobody can break their spell. Not even the Holy Virgin.
Those pure in heart have nothing to fear from demons. And I see no demons here. Only Mother Nature. Now, my dear sister Gensiana, it's from you that the monks steal the liquid fire that burns like a flame from hell. I want to get to know you.
Thank you.
Help me. I love Benedicta. Please help me. I can't help myself.
Bless you, Benedicta. You don't look well. You're sick.
I'm all right now.
Have some food with me.
Well, perhaps a little. But you must bless the food yourself before we eat. Because I was never baptized.
Never baptized? Why?
My father was considered a criminal by the church. I am his daughter, therefore a criminal also. So my parents gave me the name Benedicta and blessed me themselves. The church is very compassionate, as you know.
Do not mock the Holy Church, Benedicta. She's my life.
Yes. That is a fact I never forget.
How did you find me?
The guide told me where you were. He also said Rokas is around.
Have you seen him?
No. Not yet.
Why did you say not yet? He murdered your father. I saw it.
My father died twice. First, the people despised him. The church despised him. Even my mother despised him. To die the way he did is not fair. I can't stay any longer. I have already done what I was supposed to do.
Benedicta, what have you done to me? Oh, Holy Franciscus, forgive me. The church has servants enough. I'm not ordained yet. I can get a dispensation for my vows and be here. I can be near Benedicta and take care of her.
Dad!
One day the guide came. I was to return to the monastery. I left at once, leaving behind all the roots I had harvested. All the monks would come and get them.
May God be with you. Who are you, my sisters?
We are the fallen.
The fallen? The fallen? Surely not.
You are mistaken, Father. We are criminals. Both of us. I was a whore.
Her mother!
She's just a witch. The one you yearn for. Do not fear her. If you fight against her with yourself, may God Almighty have pity on your soul.
You saw Benedicta?
May God Almighty have pity on your soul.
It's never too late to go back.
No. There is no going back.
There is no going back.
The one who came with the sheep. The one you knew. She also brought a scourge with her. The kind you do not see. And then you do.
Scourge, what are you talking about? Pox? Oh, God. Now I can never even touch Benedicta. Oh, God.
Welcome home, Brother Ambrosius. Welcome. The superior asked me to bring you to him as soon as you arrived. By the way, you look very well.
I do feel well. The healthy climate and hard work are very good for me. You should try it.
I should try not to.
Ambrosius, I am pleased that you return with such speed. Come, sit. Now tell me, what about your soul, son? Has the Lord shown you his grace? How have you endured your probation?
In my solitude, God has given me knowledge.
Of what? Your guilt? The Lord be praised. I knew it. Solitude works wonders. Only in silence can we hear the true voice of God. You do please me, my son. Now I have good tidings for you. Good tidings. I wrote to the bishop on your behalf. He summons you to his palace. He himself will consecrate you and give you all the orders. A great honor. There's more. Afterwards, you shall remain in that city. Wonderful news, isn't it? Now prepare yourself. In 3 days, you shall leave us.
Thank you.
to look and never be able to touch. Benedict, light of my life. What if the women were lying? What if I am unharmed by this courage?
Benedicta, it's me, Ambrosius. I've come to say goodbye.
What?
I've come to say goodbye. I'm going to be ordained a priest by the bishop himself. And I have to leave.
Leave? For good? Forever?
I'm not sure. I'm worried about you. Who will keep you safe?
If you go, I have no one.
I must go.
Now that my father is gone, there is no one who even speaks to me anymore. No one I care to talk to. Except you.
Benedict.
No one even wants to look at me. Except for him.
Rokas is always around somewhere. He will never marry you, just use you. He'll try using the passion in your heart to destroy you. In this life and the after.
Do you not trust me, Ambrosius?
His intentions are false. I love you, Benedict. I shouldn't, but I do. But I must obey and follow the church.
I know. You are a holy man.
I will always pray for you. Always.
Who's there? Oh, it's you. What do you want?
Rokas. Leave Benedicta alone. Don't destroy her life.
My God, will you never stop meddling in my affairs? Get out of the way.
Rokas, I beg you. Respect Benedicta. Leave her alone.
Let me tell you something. You've been in love with her for a long time. And, that's impossible. For a monk!
No weapons. We fight on equal terms.
No weapons? Equal terms? All right.
Run! Run! Run!
to me. You understand?
Help me, Lord.
What happened?
Well, I was teaching.
Did you see Brother Ambrosius?
He's hopeless. The little monk is gone now. You see? I know.
Know what?
What I want. I know what, when, and where.
I want you to go.
Oh, I love you. Don't you want me?
No!
Yes! Yes! You want me. Don't fight your feelings.
Leave me alone!
You belong to me.
No! Stop it!
You are mine now. Do you like this knot? This is the only thing my father ever taught me.
Stop it!
You can't get rid of it. Go ahead. Go ahead, try.
Just help me.
Go ahead. No. See?
No.
Oh, that's better.
No.
That's better. That's better.
Help me. No. Please. Please.
I knew it would be like this, with you and I.
Stop, Rokas! Please! No! No! No!
We're the same kind, like brother and sister. You know what I mean. Our father knew your mother very well. You are my sister. And so you see, you do belong to me. Good start.
I hate you! I hate you!
Good
no!
Start.
I will do it. Lord, I understand everything. Now.
Rokas, he says. My brother. He says he's my brother. He's my brother.
God has shown me grace. I'm ready to be a priest. And so, here I am, a condemned killer waiting to die. Tomorrow, I shall be taken to the gallows and hanged as a common criminal. Fools we are born, and fools we die.
Why did you kill her?
To save her.
To save her from what?
You don't know what love is. To save her from you, to save her from hell.
Did she kill herself?
No!
Was she going to kill herself?
Leave her alone. She's in heaven.
Because you sent her there.
Not my will, but thine be done. Thank you.
vultures. Or Benedict is in heaven. On the 15th day of October, in the year of our Lord, 1702, in this place, I, Brother Ambrosius, was hanged. And on the following day, my body was buried near the gallows, next to that of Benedict. Pray for us.